You're watching Road to Success, the key to your next level in business. This week, our expert is Frida Owinga of Passion Profit. Welcome to our show.
Thank you so much for having me.
Frida, you own a school of entrepreneurship, which you call Passion Profit.
Yes.
And what are some of the things that you encounter with entrepreneurship when they come to join your school?
When someone is starting especially, we tend to feel we know everything. And we don't want to spend money on a consultant, a coach, or a training program because you keep thinking, I don't have money to start anyway. So why shouldn't I use this money for buying stock or getting an office or registering the company? So we make a lot of wrong mistakes, which you don't have to. And that's why you keep hearing people saying that entrepreneurship is hard. Mm-hmm. I say it doesn't have to be hard. Learn from the mistakes that have already been made. And there's so many. Why do we have to keep making the same ones? They're not sure how to prioritize what to invest in. I think investing in knowledge is important because that knowledge will help you make the right decisions and move faster.
A lot of entrepreneurs don't consider knowledge as important just because they seem to know what it is that they want.
They think they know, but running a business is more than just going somewhere, buying stuff and selling it.
Somebody like Eunice, our guest, the guest that we had earlier on, who has started her Simply Me boutique,
yes,
selling bras to breast cancer survivors.
Yes.
What advice would you give her?
Everything we start has been started somewhere else. So doing her research, is there anybody else doing this? Is there a need for it? Just from hearing about it, there is a need because there are cancer survivors. She needs to think how she, you know, what legal structure does she want to use? It doesn't have to be a social enterprise. It can be, because maybe there are women who are less advantaged,
yes,
who cannot afford and stuff like that. And then she needs to, so what kind of registration is she going to take? Where will she be getting her supplies from? How will her target audience know that she exists? Okay, and then how will she be getting her stuff and then getting her stuff out to the market? Those are some of the things that she needs to think of.
If she decides that it's a social enterprise way that she wants to do, what should she consider?
Everything that you need to start a business, you'll need to start a social enterprise. The only difference between a regular enterprise and a social enterprise is that the profit goes back to the community or into buying those services.
Okay, and then there's a difference between a social enterprise and an NGO.
The difference between social enterprise and NGO, social enterprise sell their goods, they trade, they sell goods and products to make money, to get income. NGOs get money from donors.
Is there a need? From her conversation, there is desperate need.
It's good to have a proper research so you make an informed decision. And research will tell you X number of people would need these brands every year. How would you sustain that market if you got into it? Where would you sell it? Which are the places to get these people? How much will they be able to pay?
Thank you, Frida, for taking the time. Come and share with us information that will help us as business owners. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
You're watching Road to Success, the key to your next level in business. Have a blessed week.